We often only talk about decision problems, and this might seem limiting. So for example, a decision problem is, does there exist a vertex cover of a graph of size less or equal to k? But in many cases, a more natural question for us to ask is the following. Here's a graph. Find the vertex cover that is of smallest size. What is the vertex cover of minimum cardinality? So this is called a search problem, or sometimes we might call it an optimization problem, because we are trying to minimize something. Or in other instances, we might try to maximize something, like for independent set, for example. We might want to maximize the size of the independent set. So why did we only talk about decision problems? Isn't this problematic? As it turns out, this really makes no fundamental difference. And the reason for this is called self-reducibility. For all of the problems we discussed, we have the property that the search version or the optimization version of the problem reduces to the decision version of the problem in a certain sense. To be specific, remember we had Cook reductions. And Cook reductions somehow were able to deal with problems that are not decision problems. So we could reduce some problem X to a problem Y, and X didn't necessarily have to be a decision problem. This is not true for carb reductions, but for Cook reductions, X doesn't need to be a decision problem. So what we will do is we will define something called the polynomial time Cook reduction. A polynomial time Cook reduction is just like a Cook reduction, but we require that the oracle machine runs in polynomial time. Now, self-reducibility means that the search version of a problem, polynomial time Cook reduces to the decision version of the problem. And this holds for all the problems we discussed. And what this means is that if we can solve the decision version of the problem efficiently, we can also solve the search or optimization version of the problem. We just take the search version of the problem and then apply the Cook reduction and use the algorithm that we have that is efficient for the decision version as this sub-procedure that the oracle calls. So really, the search problems are not really harder than the decision problems. Let's look at a specific example. Let's take vertex cover. I claim that if I have an algorithm that can decide whether a vertex cover of size at most k exists, I can use this to build an algorithm that finds the minimum cardinality vertex cover of a graph, and does so efficiently. So the first step is to find out what the size of the minimum vertex cover is. What is the cardinality of the minimum vertex cover? For this, we just try all different values for k. So we just ask, is there a vertex cover of size 0? If the answer is no, we just ask, okay, is there one of size 1? If the answer is no, we just say, well, is there one of size 2 then? And we keep going up until the answer is yes. So then we know what the minimum size of a vertex cover is. If you're very clever, you might say, this is very inefficient. What we really should do is we should do binary search here. So we should kind of try to narrow down the value more quickly. But both methods work in the sense that both methods will be polynomial. Because if I do this linear search, how many times will I ask the oracle at most? Well, I start at 0, and then I know there's a vertex cover of size n, when n is the number of vertices in the graph. So I will only call the oracle size of v many times. So now we know how large our final vertex cover should be. Let's call the size of the minimum vertex cover k star. Here's how we find such a vertex cover. we take the graph and we look for a vertex V such that if we remove the vertex V from the graph, then the remaining graph has a vertex cover of size at most k star minus 1. And we can check for each vertex V whether the remaining graph would have a vertex cover of size at most k star minus 1 using our oracle, using access to this algorithm for the decision problem. So we just go through all the vertices of the graph one by one. We check each one, remove it from the graph, see if the remaining graph has a vertex cover of size at most k star minus 1. If yes, we found a vertex V that works. If no, we move on to the next vertex. Now, important here is that there exists such a vertex for sure. So eventually we will find one. And the reason is that any vertex that is part of a minimum vertex cover will have this property. Suppose you have a graph G. You have this minimum vertex cover of size k star in the graph that we want to find. Now, if we remove a vertex that belongs to this vertex cover, well, then the vertex cover that is left, right, all the other vertices in the vertex cover, there will only be k star minus one of such vertices. And they will form a vertex cover of the remaining graph once we remove this vertex V. So we find such a vertex V that has this property. We know it has to exist. And then we include it in our vertex cover. We remove it from the graph. And then we repeat the procedure on the remainder of the graph. So one by one, we identify vertices that should be included in our vertex cover. And we do this until we find all k star vertices that we need. This is the entire algorithm, and this shows that if we can decide whether a graph has a vertex cover of size at most k, we can actually find such a vertex cover. And this idea works for all these problems that we've discussed. Sometimes it's a bit more difficult to come up with an algorithm that does this reduction. Sometimes it's easy. But it's possible in all cases. And this is why the restriction to decision problems was a valid thing to do, because it's not a real restriction. We get algorithms for these more interesting search problems as well.